So coming back to our atomic instructions, we have seen that we can have an atomic exchange where the problem was that it keeps writing to the lock var even when it's not available. Our test and write class of instructions is trying to avoid that by testing the memory location and only writing to it if they find a zero there. And we might implement a lock with a test and store, for example, instruction. We will implement a lock by setting R1 to 1, then testing lock var and storing R1 there. And the result we get from this test and store, let's say 0 in R1 means that the lock var was occupied, in which case we will just repeat this, try this again and again. But the idea is that as long as the lock is occupied, this test and store is only reading the lock variable, it is not writing to it. This is good because remember coherence. If you keep writing, you keep invalidating all the other copies. So everybody that is waiting keeps generating bus traffic because they're all trying to write and thus invalidating each other. In contrast, the test and store, everybody that is waiting while the lock is occupied simply gets to share the lock variable. They're all having it in the shared state and simply iterating on their cached copy. Once the lock has been freed, those shared copies are invalidated because the unlock writes to the lock variable. At this point, everybody sees the new value and tries to grab the lock. So there is really only communication on the lock when the lock becomes free until somebody acquires it again. So this test and write approach solves the problem of continuously writing to the lock variable, but doesn't really solve the problem of this is a really strange instruction. It's neither a store nor a load. It would be ideal for processor design if we could do something that is very much like a load and very much like a store yet behaves this way. And that brings us to the third type of atomic instructions, which are really now two instructions, a special load and a special store, that are somehow linked together to create an atomic instruction.